Hello and welcome to this look at the Pixel Chooser in Boris Continuum with me, Ben Brownlee from Boris FX. Now the Pixel Chooser is a defining feature of the Continuum filters. So let's have a look at how we can use them to define or limit where we apply our effects in creative and interesting ways. Let's see how we can use the Pixel Chooser in Adobe Premiere Pro, but the same functionality works in After Effects as well. The most compelling reason to use the Pixel Chooser is that it allows us to do some complex selections on where we apply our effects to, and we can do that on a single clip without doing any layers at all. We come over to our first clip. I want to apply something that makes our area around the campfire a bit warmer, whilst also giving us a little bit more darkness and definition in the sky, so sort of increasing the contrast between the two. So I'm going to start off with actually a BCC two-strip color to add a quick stylized color into the area around the fire. Now I can use my effects browser to find something that's going to be quite suitable. Actually, summer sundown, it makes a bit of sense to use something there. Now there are several different ways of changing and mixing this effect back. One of them is to use Mix with Original, which just goes over the entire clip and just mixes the strength of the effect back with the original. The other way of doing things is to come into the Pixel Chooser / Mocha, and I can turn my Pixel Chooser on, and this activates the Pixel Chooser section. And as with all the other Continuum effects, we also have presets available for our Pixel Chooser. So we can do things like an oval or matting off of the Luma channel. And we can either just use this as is, or we can come into something like the mat and start to use this just as a jumping off point. Now, as we're looking at this, I'm going to come up to View Mask Mat and turn that on. So we get a black and white representation of the mask or mat that Pixel Chooser is creating. So anything that is white is going to be 100% affected by the effect. Anything that's black is not going to be affected by the effect. And anything that's grey is going to be more or less depending on how dark or light it is. So down in the mat controls, I can choose what channel I'm going to be working on. So if I want to work on the Luma, I can do here. Or I can work on one of the colour channels or the Clips Alpha channel, or even create a key, which we'll look at a bit later. In this case, I'm going to start with the red channel, but now I can come in, change up my black and white levels as I need to. I can even add a bit of choke and a bit of blur to our clip as well. And if I turn off my matte mask, we can see what the effect is doing. In fact, it's probably easier to see the effect if I turn on compare here. Just take a look at the side by side. Now it's giving us some nice color down by the fire, but it's also affecting the sky up here as well. So let's turn off my compare for a moment and try and refine the shape with the Pixel Chooser a little bit more. So I can come into my mask now and have a look at this. We have a number of different basic spline shapes, like the egg, oval, circle, or rectangle. We also have gradients we can use. In this case, I'm just going to work with an oval here. If we have the HUD turned on in the filter, we can also see an overlay of what the Pixel Chooser is doing. So instead of scrubbing with the center points here, I just pick up and drag the shape around and use that interactivity directly within the viewer. If I turn on my matte mask now, you can see we have a combination of our oval mask and our channel matte. And I can feather out my mask very simply as well. And you can see as I mix that back now, that we're only affecting the area by the fireside. Now, as I said previously, we do have presets associated with the Pixel Chooser. And just like normal presets, we can save our own ones. And we can save these Pixel Chooser presets to a shared network drive if you're working across a team, or into the main folder with the other Pixel Chooser presets. But in this case, I'm going to save it into a regular folder on my hard drive, and I'll call it Ben Fireside Oval, and I'll replace the old one there. I'm going to add another filter over the top to try and emphasize out the sky a little bit more. And I'm going to use BCC Fast Film Process, bring that over the top. Again, use my effects browser just to kind of find one that I think is going to work quite nicely. Blue wash is kind of good. Cool wash is also quite nice. Let's go with the cool wash, hit apply on that. And now we basically want to do the opposite. We don't want the blue hitting in all the shadows, but we also don't want to hit it next to the fire either. So I'm going to open up my Pixelchooser Mocha, turn this on, and load in that preset that I just saved. And there it is, Ben Fireside Oval. Hit OK on that. And now we can see that it's only being applied into the fireside one more time. Of course, we want to do the opposite of that. So I'm going to come into my mask, come down a little bit here, and I have an invert mask checkbox, which I can just turn on. Now it's going to affect everything apart from the fireside, and it's also going to keep in that channel key as well, so it's not going to be affecting the trees and the other foliage. So if I turn this off, we can see we get that nice effect there. And I can even come in and maybe just feather out that one more time or change up the master scale just a little bit so that we're definitely not hitting any of the fireside there. So again, when we're using presets, we still have full control over them. So now if we compare this clip to the original, we can see there's quite a big difference isolated around the fireplace. Now, if we move on to our second clip, there are some filters that come with Pixelchooser already turned on. So if I apply BCC Beauty Studio to this, you can see that as soon as I apply the effect, it starts to affect the skin, but not so much the areas outside of the skin. And the reason for that is we have a look down at the Pixelchooser, is that the Pixelchooser is on, and we come into the matte, you can see it's pulling a key based off of these two default colors. If I wanted to change these colors up, I can easily just select two new colors, view my matte mask, see we've now got a nice selection on the skin. I can come in and tweak this up by clipping the black and white levels, or maybe change the areas that we're interested in, like so. Maybe even blur this up a little bit. So once again, if I turn compare on onto the side by side, and we'll just slide that over, you can now see we've got a huge effect happening on this particular frame. And we can go into our smoothing and start to change things up. I don't want quite as large an effect as this. If I turn on color correction, we can even use the mask just to affect where we apply that color correction. So if I add a little bit of brightness up here, quite a lot of brightness, that's a bit too much. Maybe bring to about 6, and we'll touch the saturation down to even that out. There we go. Maybe just reduce the contrast. Now if I turn the compare off and we take a little look through, you see that's mainly affecting the skin. I say mainly affecting the skin because if we turn the effect on and off here, you see that maybe some of the areas outside and definitely on the shoulder here are also being affected by the filter. And if we don't want that, we can build on top of our key with another type of mask. So if I come back down into my Pixelchooser, I can go Mocha Mask Track and just click on this button. And this launches a version of Boris Mocha built in to the Pixelchooser. And everywhere where we see Pixelchooser Mocha, we have Mocha available to us. And Mocha allows us to draw more complex splines and track them. In this case, we're just going to track the face backwards, and it allows us to harness the power of Mocha directly within our Boris Continuum plugins. And as Mocha is a planar tracker, it allows us to do some quite tricky tracks with a minimum of fuss. And as we finish up our track now, I can come in and make some small changes as I need to this particular shape, just to take in a bit more of the face. But as you can tell, it doesn't affect the main track, and we just get this nice marsh shape with the minimum of fuss. What I can also do, if I want to subtract the mouth from this selection, is I can make another shape for the mouth, bring that over there, and I will call this one Mouth Mask, and call our bottom layer Face Track, and I can connect my mouth mask to the face track so that I don't have to retrack this. All I have to do is come in and make any sort of small necessary changes as and when I need to. Again, just using the power of the original track that we already had to just tighten up the mask around the mouth. And before I leave, I'm going to come in and set my blend mode on the mouth to subtract so that it's taking it out of the selection. So now if I exit out and come back into Premiere and have a look at the mask matte, we can see we've now isolated that area around the face, taking out the mouth as well. And of course, I can come into that mask and just feather it out as I need to. Just make that a little bit less harsh. So now our effect is only focused on the face. You can see the differences, and I can even come in and make further changes as I need to, focused only on the face. And as you can see, Pixelchooser is a very, very powerful feature in the Continuum plugin set. And that's how we can begin to use it in Adobe Premiere Pro. If you found this video useful, then remember to hit the like button. For more ways to master Boris Continuum in Adobe, subscribe to the Boris FX YouTube channel and check out our other tutorials. If there's something missing, then let me know in the comments below. My name's Ben Brownlee from Boris FX. Thanks for now.